Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us is Deferred Tax Liabilities. Now DTA, over here we have taken example of Ford's Motor. Ford Motors has, you know, at the initial end of 2010, there was a higher side of DTL, and then there was a completely significant decline. I mean, you see the drop is quite more till 2012, and the decline continued, and there was a little fluctuation, but stability was maintained. Post facto, it reached to 815 million. So it started in billions, 2.4, and it ended up in $8.5 million. So what is this all about? Well, first and the foremost thing that we are going to discuss is what are DTL, what are the deferred tax liabilities? See, deferred tax liabilities are created when the income tax expenses, that is the income tax expenses, is greater than the tax payable, right, or the tax returns, and the difference is expected to reverse in the future. So DTL is the amount of the income taxes which are payable in the future period as a result of the taxable temporary differences. Now, first, deferred tax liabilities are created when the amount of the IT expenses, as I told you, are greater than the tax payable, right? So this can happen when the expenses or losses are tax deductible before they are recognized in the income statement. And over here, the accounting income is greater than the taxable income, right? And then there is a future taxable amounts, and then the deferred tax liability, right? Okay, now we'll try and understand the meaning of this. See, before discussing the deferred tax liabilities, it is very important to understand the certain concepts which will help us to understand why DTL is created. In general, the GAAP and IFRS, okay, differs from the tax laws of the country. This results in the difference between income tax expense recognized in the income statement and the actual amount of the tax owed to the tax authority. So due to these differences, the deferred tax liabilities and assets are created. The income tax expenses, you know, equations, and that equates, you know, the tax expenses recognized in the income statement and the tax payables to the tax authorities, changes, you know, in deferred tax assets and deferred tax liabilities. So the income tax expense will go something like this, is equal to your tax payable plus your DTL minus your DTA. So the deferred tax example, we will take this. That's the next thing that we need to incorporate, the example part. See, a good deferred tax liability example is when the firm uses an accelerated depreciation method, EDM, for the tax purpose, and the straight line SLM depreciation for the financial reporting. So deferred tax liability keeps into account the fact that the company in future will pay more income tax because of the transaction that has happened in the current time period, for the example of installment sale receivable. Let's say deferred tax liability example, you know, below the company's income statement for the financial reporting purpose, as you know, reported to the shareholder, we have not charged the income and the expenses number, so that, you know, the highlight deferred tax liability concept. Here we assumed that the asset is worth $1,000 with a useful life of 3 years and is depreciated using the SLM method of depreciation. Now, you know, here is a detail of year 1, 2 and 3. There's revenue, cost of goods sold and some other details that have been mentioned. The asset over here is going to be worth of $1,000. As I told you, all of the details, and the depreciation using straight line method for $1,000 for 3 years is going to be $333 for 1 year, right? That's how the details are going to go. The depreciation, as you can see, all the numbers, and then the post facto is the net income. So we note that, you know, the tax expenses is $350 for all the 3 years. Now let's assume that for the tax purposes, the company uses the accelerated method of depreciation. So the depreciation profile is year one is going to be, instead of 333, it's going to be 500. It's going to be 500. Year two, it's again going to be 500. And year three is going to be zero. So accordingly, your tax payable will reduce down to 300, 300 and 450, right? So we note, you know, the tax payable for year one comes down to 300. For second year, 300 and 450. You know, as discussed, when we use the two different kind of depreciation for financial reporting and for tax purpose, it results into deferred taxes. Now, I'll take you to the calculation part of the DTL. See, income tax expense is equal to your tax payable plus DTL minus DTA. Okay, so the deferred tax formula is income tax expense minus tax payable plus DTA. So for year one, Y1 was how much? It was 350 minus 300 plus zero. So no change. How about I'll just take all this number, control X and control V. So that will be 50. For Y2, it was for us 350, right? It was 350 initial profit. Then it was 300 plus there'll be no change in DTA. And for Y3, it's 350 minus 450 plus zero. That's going to be minus 100. All these numbers are taken from here, 350 and 300, right? So cumulative differences over here, you know, our deferred tax liability on the balance sheet is our example. And the Y1 DTL is going to be 50. Y2 will be accumulated 50 plus 50. And Y3 cumulative DTL is going to be 100 minus 100. So that's going to be zero. So note, you know, the effective reversal is there in the year three part. Now I want you to make you understand what are the reasons for deferred tax liability. See, the difference in timing of the revenue and expenses recognition income statements and the tax returns. That's the first one. Second, certain revenues and expenses are recognized in the income statement but are never on the tax return or the vice versa. Third, the assets and the liabilities have different carrying amounts, net value of the assets or liability in the balance sheet and the tax basis, right? Fourth, gains and losses recognition in the income statement differs from the tax returns, and the tax losses from the prior period may offset the future taxable income. Fifth, financial statement adjustments may not have affect the tax return or may be recognized in the different period of time. Sixth, breaking down the deferred tax liability. See, DTL is created when the revenues or expenses are recognized and in the income statement before the taxable income. For example, in the firm often recognizes the earning of the subsidiary before any distribution, that is dividend, that has been made, and eventually the DTL will be reversed when the taxes are been paid. So after all of this, let me make my final conclusion. See, to summarize, if the taxable income, that is as per the tax return, if it is less than the pre-tax income, and the difference is expected to reverse in the future year, a deferred tax DTL is created, and DTL will be result in the future cash outflow when the taxes are paid. DTL is most commonly created when an accelerated depreciation method is used on the tax returns, and straight line SLM, the straight line depreciation, is used on the income statement. Now for an analyst, this is the line item of the financial statement is very important, as if the DTL is expected to reverse in the future, then they are considered as the liability, otherwise it will be considered as the equity part.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.